for all. Five, four. So it's over. 5-0.
We're back, as you can see, it's mixed doubles. The technical delay on the commentary sound. Images. See on court.
Six.
In white for Ireland.
Five.
Sam and Chloe McGee. In black, representing Denmark, Nicholas Nor, Sarah Higginson. Very, very difficult draw for the Irish this year.
7-5.
Yeah, Sarah, I know a lot of. Sarah won alongside Anders Skarup Rasmussen, mixed doubles national title in Denmark, which is no mean feat.
8-5.
You consider the level of badminton in Denmark. So, accomplished player. Newer partnership now with Nicholas Nor.
Service over. 6-8. Service over. 9-6.
Speaking to the Irish for the tournament. You know, always a lot of pressure on your home event, no matter where it may be. But the sport sees even more pressure.
Out.
But really in a tough side.
Service over.
Any Danish
7-9.
Tricky. Then like even if they get through this likely matchup with English.
Court 5, game. 20 seconds.
Danes taking the first game, 23-21. Really serious errors from the Irish handing the game. Noor and Tigerson cannot afford to do that against Danish opposition.
Second game. Lavall. Play.
Certainly quite happy to lift to Sam to rear court. Sam.
Service over.
Hardest.
One.
In the love. World. Good drops on that occasion. Good angle.
Service over. One. All. It's over.
Better rally from
two,
the Irish.
2-1. Three, one.
This time from Sam. Yeah, assertive, aggressive, and everything good about mixed doubles. Again, Nicholas arguing the point about the serve. You know, sooner or later, this service judge is going to call one. Just from the amount of pressure the Danes are putting on him.
Maybe.
No,
maybe they'll change the service. I have to say, Chloe fired one serve in the first set. I would not have been happy.
Out. Service over. 2-3. Service over. 4-2.
And the lead here. It's essential to stay on half of his
game. 5-2.
He's really just fantastic, but he has to stay on.
Yeah. Poor shot.
6-2.
Still had to be onto it. 6-2. Good lead for the Irish. Nice play from midcourt from Sam.
Service over, 3-6.
Ah, definitely hit the line. But indecision from the line judge, and that's what that's the worst thing you can have.
I know it's early in the day, but so far, better than
yesterday. If you're going to call it out, just call it out. If you're going to call it in, just call it in, but do it and make it assertive.
Service over.
Yeah, yeah.
7,
yeah. Do you want
three.
It in or do you want it out?
Can't clear the see it, the indecision more than anything.
Service over.
We saw the
error
at the net.
Seven.
Sam giving the we've seen the replay
change.
Giving the first game away, but see it here again. Nice backhand.
Service over. 8-4. Nine, four.
Again, getting good traction from this flick serve off Chloe. Oh, great smash from Nicholas.
So it's over. 5-9.
You know what, it's a feature of, it's starting to become a real feature of mixed doubles.
Foot. Service over. 10-6.
Yeah. We're flicking the girl and pushing her away from the net. You know?
Foot. Service over. 7-10. Foot. 8-10.
Now just starting to eat into this lead of the Irish. Another flick. That's two
Nine,
really good flicks
ten.
From Nicholas. Very, very good at disguising that flick. This is, you know, it's going short, Sarah. Good variety.
10-10.
Superb shot.
Service over. 11-10.
Got off to a good start, but a good comeback from the Danes. And certainly the two flick serves, Nicholas catching the Irish unawares. They're going to have to certainly be very aware of the effectiveness of his serve. I don't know, Tom Reedy is saying at the moment, very animated, issuing the orders to Sam and Chloe.
Court 5, 20 seconds.
1980s
court 5, 20 seconds.
With the collar turned up.
He had his 92 Olympic shoes on yesterday.
Okay, yeah. So he's got them resold a good few times at this stage.
Jesse brings them out once a year.
We have mould on them.
11,
you're tweeting, 10. Hashtag CIO.
Play.
How much of a disadvantage do you think it is for the Danes not having any coaching?
Service over. 11 all.
If you asked me that maybe 4 years ago, I would have said it's a huge disadvantage. But I see it widespread now on the badminton, on the European circuit, where players are literally traveling on their own because it of the financial restrictions brought on by the global recession. And as a result, I've seen so many players come of age, having to fight for themselves and work it out for themselves. The likes of, I know Fernando is a really, really top player.
Service over.
Carolina and Beatrice.
12, 11.
Could not go to a lot of tournaments, say, a year and a half ago. And they had to literally fend for themselves. They grew a little bit.
I think it teaches self-reliance.
Yeah.
When I was younger, always travel, always have a coach, and then you spend 4 years on the road.
Yeah.
And you can't look to the chair for answers. What are you going to do?
Yeah, like, you know, you have to make the difference on the court. Okay, for some players who function better
service over
a coach, there's some who
12
all without a coach. I saw at the Scottish Open, and we'll go back to the Spanish again, Beatriz Corrales has decided that she does not want her coach to come in at the interval. She wants to figure it out for herself, but he's still there if he needs her, that, you know, she can turn and talk to him. So certainly nowadays it's not as much as importance put on it, in my opinion. Players are much more adaptable on their own.
Service over.
Honestly,
13.
Community, I wonder,
12.
I actually questioned the need for the coaching at some points. All the way. 13-12.
Okay. 14-12.
He's fighting very hard here to keep control of this game. They want this.
This is their home tournament.
Home tournament, first round. Don't want to open their week with this as a loss.
Of course, Chloe has won the Irish International before. Women's doubles.
Service over.
7, I think it was.
13-14.
25 years old. Chloe's birthday just the other day, so. Back then, she was just out of nappies.
14 all.
Nice return, Chloe.
Catch the line.
Oh, that was out. It was pulled in.
It'll be interesting how the umpire handles this one.
Overruled, I think.
15.
I have to say the umpires are being quite...
14.
This week it quickly overruling questionable line calls.
Yeah, they've been kept on their toes for sure.
I was just about to say that I think this game...
16. 14.
A lot more aggressive in the game, and he needs to be doing this more often. But then again, that's an easy opportunity there hitting net. Suddenly the Danes will take the lead.
That's out.
Out. Out. Service over. 15.
You see,
16.
Nicholas knew that was out, but he still had a look to the umpire to see was he going to call it in, because, you know, he knows that the line judging is a little bit suspect.
That creates stress, doesn't it?
Fair affects the game. And unfortunately, it's something that the Irish are
service
going to,
over.
Have to really grab a hold of, because we've had
17,
a couple of years
15.
In a row. Standard of the line judging, unfortunately, has not been good enough. It hasn't been. It hasn't equaled the level of play. And it's just a fact. I travel all over, and I've seen the level of line judging increase and get better. The standard of line judging at the Scottish Open 3 weeks ago was exceptional.
Foot. 18, 15.
Slipping away from the Irish duo.
Foot. Service over.
Double hit. Yeah.
16, 18.
I think it was a double hit. Danish side of the net.
Out. Service over. Sorry, correction. 17, 18.
Of course, you know, the little bit of discussion with the service will also put a little bit of pressure on the player serving. Yeah.
Out.
Oh, and then a
service over.
Serve from Chloe.
19, 1-0
for me,
17.
Alistair.
Foot.
Yeah.
Service over.
To be honest, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I think it's right 18, on the edge. That flick serve of her is right on the edge.
I think she's pulling the racket head up above her wrist, driving it a little. She certainly did in the first set. Probably going to hit me after. But there was certainly one with the racket. I don't see how you can drive like that without bringing the racket head up. And I certainly felt it when one in the first set. I think that set
19 all. He's out. Shuttle is out.
He's challenging every line call now because he sees the indecision from the line judges. Critical part of the game, but it's also disrupting the match. Now what we had there was effectively the Irish coaches calling the line. 19 all. Great shot from Sam. Oh, wrong option. Should have gone down
service
the line.
Service over.
I think coming cross court with the woman
20,
standing tall at the net.
Match point, yeah. 19.
It's match point for the Danes. Sarah serving Chloe McGee. Flick serve. That time better push down the line from Sam.
Oh. Service over.
Yeah, hanging in there. But I thought Sarah had the opportunity, the little lift.
20
little
all.
It's a little bit high down her forehand side. Some nerves on the Danish side of the net. She'll have to go and win it. 20 all, somehow the Irish dragged themselves back into this game. Great interception, great play from Sam McGee.
Irish hold on.
21, 20.
17 and now turned that around and have one game point.
A fantastic get from Chloe there.
Oh!
Service over!
Skills from Dickinson.
21 all! 22. Yep. 21.
Of the net.
Get himself another match point.
See the shuttle landing a long way out in the replay. Again, as you said, Alistair, another match point on the serve of Nicholas Knorr.
Service over.
Another match point save.
22 all.
Let's see how relaxed Sam is on the serve.
I'm not relaxed.
Really great smash. The flick serve is really deep.
23-22.
Game point again.
Gibbs.
Really.
Tough.
Indecision on the
second
replay.
Game won by Sam McGee, Chloe McGee, 24-22.
The Irish
one game all.
Game 24-22, and really when it looked to be going against them, trailing 18-15, 19-17. Good composure, and you could see on the court we were right behind Chloe and Sam. They're gone the other side now, but you could see Chloe, the calming figure in the partnership, talking to Sam and calming him down. And to be fair to Sam, played some really clever shots. And the Irish made very few mistakes towards the end of that game. Good play from the Irish.
Yeah, I'm just watching the Danish show. No coach, but again, communicating quite well with each other.
But I think Nicholas needs to forget about these challenging line calls, talking to service judges.
He's getting a little bit annoyed, I think, between the serving and the service judge.
Yeah. So we're one game all, but it's now the Irish with the momentum going into the final set.
Are you ready? Final game. Love all. Play.
Final game. Big serve again from Chloe. Yeah. This time Chloe with the racket nice and high.
One. Love.
Oh, I thought Nicholas was heading over for for an argument with the service judge. Whew, it was just a shuttle change.
Yeah. Out. Service over. One all. Service over. 2-1.
Oh! Unbelievable defense from the Irish. I think Nicholas felt he had that rally won. Aggressive punch clear from Sam.
Service over.
In the end,
all
smash from Nicholas Knorr down the line. Clip in the net. to all.
Should we just fast forward to 18-0?
So it's over. Three.
A lot of that from the goal from this game. Service errors. Service errors to the man. You know, the pressure is on them. They feel when they're serving to the man.
Foot. Receiver.
Move. Oh. Fault receiver.
4-2.
Yeah. Superb backhand cross court from the Dane. Tempo in the rally is just lifted a little bit, I think, in this third game. Nice stick smash from Nicholas. Full smash for the winner.
Service over. 3-4.
Certainly. The fault receiver now will be gone from his mind after that good winner.
Good. Service over.
Very quick.
5-3. Service over. 4-5.
She's quite a, you know, she's deceptively taller than she looks. She's got a really good reach and she's got a real strength in those legs and that right arm.
She brings power with it though. She uses her height, but she's powerful. She's bringing it down aggressively to the right place.
Of rackets from the Danes.
Very, very good anticipation.
Service over. 6-4.
Maintaining this 2-point margin, the Irish. Think it's okay?
I think it's okay, personally.
7-4. Good.
Ooh, it's frustration. No.
8-4.
Lashing out at the shuttle.
Good. Service over. 5-8. Service over. 9-5. Service over. 6-9.
Dane's hanging in there.
Service over.
Lazy backhand, I think. Zara.
10-6. Service over. 7-10.
Spanish on the return. Sam certainly a lot more aggressive in this third game. Technique, pull, drop shot.
Service over. 11-7.
Drop shot was
interval.
Has to be executed from Sam McGee. You can see Tom Reedy now just a little bit calmer as he comes to his players. Interval lead 11-7. Looked like a dire situation towards the end of that second game. Oh, we see Emil Holst has now come in.
Coach,
Danish pair.
Service over, court 5, 20 seconds.
Drop shot.
Inter court 5, 20 seconds.
Again, for me, too many voices at the mid-game interval. You have two coaches saying, no matter how much you're on the same wavelength, it has to be a mixed signal coming.
On the Irish side?
On the Irish side. Whatever side, if there was two of anybody.
Yeah, we had this conversation at the international.
11-7.
To me, too much. You can only take in so much information. You know, 20 seconds or whatever it is, half a minute. European Junior Singles Champion in 2009 in men's singles, yep.
I think there's occasion for this. Sometimes it is effective for a coach to come in at this point and just correct a few things because the Danes are looking a little bit stuck.
Yeah.
And they've come out a little bit more energized now.
9-11.
Flashes going off behind the Danish pair. I wonder how distracting that is to the Irish.
Great shot from Sam, taking space. That's what I like about Sam. He has the ability to put tight spaces.
Yeah.
12-9.
They're maintaining this lead, Alistair. You know, they've come out of the blocks in this third and deciding game a little bit more about them, a little bit more aggressive, a little bit more intensity to their game, and they've maintained this three-point lead. Danes looking a little bit insecure. Nice execution on the drop from Sam. Oh, superb net from Chloe. No chance that shuttle was ever going to come back.
Chloe.
Yeah, rolling over the net tape.
14-9.
Really, if the McGees go on to take this, Alistair, you would really have to give them credit where it's due, because it looked like a lost cause at one point towards the end of that second game.
They're playing like different players now, particularly Sam. Second and third game, Sam has played with a lot more intent. I'd like to see him start games with that sort of intent.
And the other on the backhand.
10-14.
I know Sam very well. I spend a lot of time with Sam, and he comes and does a little bit of coaching. But Ben, I tell Richard Vaughan that, because I'm not allowed to do that in my club. But it's about an hour drive up and down to my club, and I come and pick him up. So we've plenty of time for badminton discussions on the journey. Of course, Sam has spent many hours in the commentary box with me up and down the European circuit.
Service over. 15.
15-10. 10. Still have to go and win it. Body language, very frustrated.
Just starting to get away from 16-10. First hand slap of the match.
For me personally, I think this is the crucial point now, one way or the other. With 17-10, it's a long way back. 16-11, the Danes will still feel they're in with a chance.
Service over.
Yeah, that was one of those silly errors that he was making earlier in the match. Keep it in. If you have to lift it, lift. I started playing badminton with no net. 19-17. Again, it's Chloe. A calming figure in the partnership. One year, Sam Senior. Nice, that was a nice flick. It's going right down the line. Oh, I think he was a little bit lucky there. You see it lifting. Certainly the opportunity there for Sarah to kill that.
Match
the net intercept, maybe the push down the line might have been the option. But the net result is match point for the Irish. A flattish flick serve this time. From that's it. They've done it, and now the frustration again comes out from Nicholas Knorr. Not happy with the serve.
He's not happy. I think I want to have to go to the hand.
Yeah, it has to be done. But in the end, it's the McGee's who come in the through in the third game, 21-17. Stay tuned. Shortly, we'll have an interview with Sam and Chloe. And
By Sam McGee, Chloe McGee.
On
21-23,
thereafter will be
24-22, 21-17.
And singles, it'll be Gabriel Lundell of Sweden against Pablo Abian. Oh no, sorry, my mistake, mixed doubles. Bauman and Bauman against Golinski and Corvillan of Belgium.
Two developing players and getting better, and probably Ahrens, if you get by that, Ahrens and Peak in the next round. So a big challenge for you this week.
Yeah, I think after that match we're not thinking about winning anything, we're just thinking next match now, because we're just happy to be in the next round after that, because I think a lot of people would have bet on us to be out by now, but somehow we got a second chance, so it's a good chance now to go and just play.
Hey, like, okay. Yeah, I know.
Well done.
Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well done. Well
done.